special love to all my friends at the fountains. It seems as if some of the restrictions are starting to lift, which is really wonderful. New York and Connecticut have been behaving themselves, and so that's really good news. Hopefully we will be able to see each other face to face in real life soon. So today, we are going to be listening to music from The Music Man, a really, really fun play. It was written by the book, the music, and the lyrics were all written by Meredith Wilson, based on a story by Wilson himself and Franklin Lacey. The plot concerns con man Harold Hill, who pretends to be a boys band organizer and leader. By the way, then, to that end, he sells band instruments and uniforms, goes to Midwestern towns, and promises to have a band, train the members of the band, give them lessons, but he's not a musician, and he's always skipped town before giving any actual music lessons. In the town, there's a prim librarian and piano teacher, Marion. She sees through him, but when Harold helps her younger brother overcome his lisp and social awkwardness, Marion begins to fall in love. Harold risks being caught by the authorities to win her. So a little bit of background first about the show. In 1957, became a hit on Broadway, winning 5 Tony Awards, including Best Musical. The cast album won the first Grammy Award for Best Musical Theater Album. The show's success led to a popular 1962 film adaptation and a 2003 television adaptation. Every year, it's presented by professional and amateur theater companies and is a repertoire staple for high school musicals. In fact, I was the music director for The Music Man at Dover High School a few years ago. This was Meredith Wilson's first musical, and he was inspired by his boyhood in Mason City, Iowa. He began developing this theme in his 1948 memoir, And There I Stood with My Piccolo. He first pitched the project as a television special. Then he tried MGM, but no luck, nobody was interested. After a few more unsuccessful attempts to get this produced, Wilson invited Franklin Lacey to help him edit and simplify the libretto. Good thing he did. So after years of development, a change of producers, almost 40 songs, 22 were finally cut. That's how much music and material he had. More than 40 drafts, the original Broadway production opened in December 1957 at the Majestic Theater. It had 1,375 performances and ended its run in April 1961. The original cast included Robert Preston, who was also in the 1962 film adaptation, as Harold Hill. Robert Preston claimed that he got the role of Harold Hill despite his limited singing range, because when he went to audition, they were having the men sing You Got Trouble, which is more of a patter song. Barbara Cook starred as Marion on Broadway. Shirley Jones played the role in the 1962 film. The character of Marion the Librarian, Marion Peru was her full name, was inspired by Marion Seeley of Provo, Utah, who met Wilson during World War II when she was a medical records librarian. In the original production and the film, the school board was played by the Buffalo Bills, who were the 1950 International Quartet Champions of the Society for the Preservation and Encouragement of Barbershop Quartet Singing in America, SBESQUA. Wilson actually wrote a book about all his adventures getting this show to Broadway, and it was called But He Doesn't Know the Territory. And listen to that phrase, that's part of the very first patter song, and you'll hear that in there as the salesmen are talking to each other. The Music Man is set in a fictional town, River City, Iowa, in 1912. And as I've mentioned, the town is based in a large part on Wilson's birthplace, Mason City, Iowa. And many of the musical's characters are based on people that Wilson observed in the town. The river in River City is probably the Mississippi River near Davenport, Iowa. The Rock Island conductors announcing River City, Iowa, cigarettes illegal in this state, implies crossing the Mississippi from Rock Island, Illinois, into Iowa. From the vantage point of 1957, the year 1912 was a time of relative innocence, before two world wars, before the Great Depression, and before the arrival of the atom bomb, which was on everybody's mind during that time. The musical also includes many references to popular culture of the time. For example, in making his pitch, Harold Hill lists popular musicians and composers, some of the ones mentioned, Pat Conway, W.C. Handy, and John Philip Sousa. But interesting, some of the cultural references are anachronistic. You Got Trouble contains references to Captain Billy's Whiz Bang, which was a monthly humor magazine, but that didn't become popular or even published until October 1919. He also mentions the non-alcoholic near beer, Bevo, which was first brewed in 1916. These all came after this 1912. The original cast recording was released in 1958, both in stereo and mono, which was a very big deal in those days. It held the number one spot on the Billboard charts for 12 weeks, remaining on the charts for a total of 245 weeks. That's over 4 years. That's amazing. The first recording of Till There Was You was actually released before the original cast album version. Promotional copies were released in November 1957. This was even before the Broadway production had premiered. It was produced by Nelson Riddle. It featured his orchestra and a 17-year-old vocalist, Sue Rainey. The song has been covered by many artists, including the Beatles, on one of their first albums. In fact, Wilson's widow later told the New York Times that his estate made more money from the royalties of the Beatles' recording of Till There Was You than it did from the musical. The New York Times theater critic, Brooks Atkinson, wrote in his review, "The Music Man is as American as apple pie and a Fourth of July oration, a marvelous show rooted in wholesome and comic tradition." So now, let's start listening to some of the music. We'll go through the story. It's early summer, 1912, and we're aboard a train leaving Rock Island, Illinois. There's a group of traveling salesmen, and they're debating whether all these newfangled ideas and contraptions, all this modern innovation, is that making their profession more difficult? Someone brings up Professor Harold Hill, who has legendary sales. So here we are listening to Rock Island.
Territory.
Doesn't know the
territory?
What's a fella's line?
Never worries about his line.
Never worries about his line.
Or a doggone thing. He's just a bang, beat, bell, ringing, big, hole, great, gold, neck, or nothing, rip, roar, and every time a bullseye salesman. That Professor Harold Hill, Harold Hill.
What's a fella's line? What's his line?
He's a fake, and he doesn't know the territory.
Look, what do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
He's a music man.
He's a what? He's a what?
He's a music man, and he sells clarinets to the kids in the town with the big trombones and the rat-a-tat drums. Big brass face, and the piccolo with uniforms, too, with a shiny gold braid on the coat and a big red stripe running.
Well, I don't know much about bands, but I do know you can't make a living selling big trombones. No, sir. Mandolin picks, perhaps, and here and there a jew's harp.
No, the fella sells bands, boys' bands. I don't know how he does it, but he lives like a king, and he dallies, and he gathers, and he plucks, and he shines. And when the man dances, certainly, boys, what else? The piper pays him. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. When the man dances, certainly, boys, what else? The piper pays him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But he doesn't know the territory.
It's really quite wonderful. So clever. This is one of my favorite pieces in this. All right, so we heard one of the salesmen saying that Hill is a con man who promises to form boys' marching bands, then skips town after taking payments for instruments and uniforms. The train arrives in River City, Iowa. A passenger leaves the train with a suitcase labeled Professor Harold Hill. He walks into the town, asks for some information, a hotel maybe, but the townspeople of River City are rather cold. They then described their reserved, quote, chip-on-the-shoulder attitude. So this next example is Iowa stubborn. And it's the people of Iowa gently making fun of a very reserved, not entirely welcoming persona.
Oh, there's nothing halfway about the Iowa way to treat you when we treat you,
which we may not do at all. There's an Iowa kind, the special chip on the shoulder, attitude we've never been without.
That we recall.
We can be cold as a falling thermometer in December if you ask about the weather in July.
We're so by God stubborn we could stand touch and noses for a week at a time and never see eye to eye.
But what the heck? You're welcome. Come make us out of the picnic.
You can eat yourself of all the food you bring yourself.
You really ought to give Iowa a try.
Provided you were contrary.
Morning, Mayor Shin.
Good morning, Mayor Shin.
It is if you want to go around your drawers all day.
We can be cold as a falling thermometer in December if you ask about our weather in July. And we're so by God stubborn we can stand touch and nose us for a week at a time and never see eye to eye. But we'll give you our shirt and a back to go.
Marcellus has gone legit now. He now lives in the town, has settled down. Marcellus tells Harold that Marion Peru, the librarian who gives piano lessons, is the only trained musician in town. He also tells Hill that a new pool table was just delivered in the town's local billiard parlor. So to launch his scheme, Harold needs to convince River City parents of the trouble that can come from a pool table. So here is the very famous song, You Got Trouble, right here in River City.
Well, you got trouble, my friend. Right here, I say trouble right here in River City. Why, sure, I'm a billiard player. Certainly mighty proud to say I'm always mighty proud to say it. I consider that the hours I spend with a cue in my hand are golden. Help me cultivate horse sense and a cool head and a keen eye. Did you ever think I'm trying to give an ironclad leave to yourself from a three-rail billiard shop? But just as I say it takes judgment, brains, and maturity to score in a bog-line game, I say that any boob can take and shove a ball in a pocket. And I call that sloth the first big step on the road to the depths of degradation. I say first, medicinal wine from a teaspoon, then beer from a bottle. And the next thing you know, your son is playing for money in a pinchback suit. And listening to some big out-of-town jasper, hearing him tell about horse race gambling. Not a wholesome trotting race, no, but a race where they set down right on the horse. Like to see some stuck-up jockey boy setting on Dan Patch, make your blood boil, well, I should say. Now, friends, let me tell you what I mean. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pockets in a table. Pockets that mark the difference between a gentleman and a bum, with a capital B, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for fool. And all week long, your River City youth will be frittering away. I say your young men will be frittering. Frittering away there, noontime, supper time, chore time too. Get the ball in the pocket. Never mind getting dandelions pulled to the screen door, patched to the beefsteak fountain. Never mind pumping any water till your parents are caught with a cistern empty on a Saturday night, and that's trouble. Yes, you got lots and lots of trouble. I'm thinking of the kids in the Knickerbocker, shirt-tail young ones, peeking in the pool hall window after school. You got trouble, folks, right here in River City. Trouble with a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool. Now, I know all you folks are the right kind of parents. I'm going to be perfectly frank. Would you like to know what kind of conversation goes on while they're loafing around that hall? They were trying out Bevo, trying out Cubabs, trying out TaylorMades like cigarette fiends, and bragging all about how they're going to cover up a telltale breath with sense. And one fine night, they leave the pool hall, heading for the dance of the armory, libertine men and scarlet women, and ragtime, shameless music that'll grab your son, your daughter, with the arms of a jungle, animal instinct, masteria. Friends, the idle brain is the devil's playground. Trouble!
Oh, yes, oh.
Right here in River City.
Right here in River City.
With a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool.
Pool.
We surely got trouble.
We sure got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here.
Gotta figure out a way to keep the young ones moral after school. Mothers of River City, heed that warning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The minute your son leaves the house, does he rebuckle his knickerbockers below the knee? Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger? A dime novel hidden in the corn crib? Is he starting to memorize jokes from Cap'n Billy's whiz bang? Are certain words creeping into his conversation? Words like swell. Aha! And so's your old man. And so, my friends, we got trouble.
Oh, we got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here in River City.
With a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool.
That stands for pool.
We surely got trouble.
We sure got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here.
Remember the Maine, Plymouth Rock, and the Golden Rule. We got trouble. We're in terrible, terrible trouble. That game with the 15 numbered balls is the devil's tool. Yes, we got trouble, trouble, trouble.
Oh, yes, we got trouble. We got big, big trouble.
With a G.
With a capital
T. Rhymed with P.
Rhymed with P.
Stands for pool.
That stands for pool.
Remember, my friends, listen to me because I passed this way, but what?
All right, so he's revving up the town folk, talking against this pool table, setting them up so then he can give them something wholesome later on. Okay, but now part of his plan is also to get Marion the librarian on his side, and Harold follows Marion home, and he attempts to flirt with her, and she totally ignores him. In her house, Marion gives a piano lesson to a little girl named Amaryllis. At the same time the piano lesson is going on, she's arguing with her widowed mother. They all live together, about her high standards where men are concerned. And there is some discussion about the man who followed her home. So this next example is two things. It's the piano lesson and also a song, If You Don't Mind My Saying So.
Mama, a man with a suitcase followed me home.
Oh?
I never saw him before.
Did he say anything?
He tried.
Did you say anything?
Of course not, Mama. Now don't dawdle, Amaryllis.
So do la re ti mi a little slower, and please keep the fingers curved as nice and high as you possibly can.
Don't get faster, dear.
If you don't mind my saying so, it wouldn't have hurt you to have found out what the gentleman wanted.
I know what the gentleman wanted.
What, dear?
You'll find it in Balzac.
Excuse me for living, but I never read it.
Neither has anyone else in this town.
There you go again with the same old comment about the low mentality of River City people and taking it all too much to heart.
Now, Mama, as long as the Madison Public Library was entrusted to me for the purpose of improving River City's cultural level, I can't help my concern that the ladies of River City keep ignoring all my counsel and advice.
But, darling, when a woman has a husband and you've got none, why should she take advice from you?
Do you think that I'd allow a common masher? Now, really, Mama, I have my standards where men are concerned, and I have no intention.
I know all about your standards, and if you don't mind my saying so, there's not a man alive who could hope to measure up to that blend of Paul Bunyan, St. Pat, and all the ways to you concocted for yourself. Out of your Irish imagination, you know, I was stubborn to send an library full of books.
That was a mouthful. Okay, so they're kind of bickering there. About, you can imagine there's a poor kid, Amaryllis, just sort of sitting, you know, watching this going back and forth. Okay, then Marion's self-conscious 10-year-old brother, Winthrop, arrives home. Now, Amaryllis, the little girl receiving the piano lesson, secretly likes Winthrop, but being a child, she teases him about his lisp. And Amaryllis asks Marion, to whom should she say goodnight on the Evening Star, since she doesn't have a sweetheart? Marion tells her to just say goodnight to her someone, her special someone. So now we're going to hear Goodnight, My Someone.
Thank you.
right, the scene shifts now. The next day, Mayor Shin and his rather overbearing wife, Eulalie McKechnie Shin, lead the festivities for Independence Day at the high school gym. But they're interrupted by a firecracker set off by troublemaker Tommy. Harold takes the stage, announces to the townspeople that he will prevent sin and corruption from the pool table by forming a boys' band. And he sings one of the most well-known songs from this play, 76 Trombones. Yeah, we'll get there.
Please, folks, may I have your attention, please? Attention, please. I can deal with the troubled friends with a wave of my hand, this very hand. Please observe me, if you will. I'm Professor Harold Hill, and I'm here to organize a River City Boys Band. Oh, think, my friends, how can any pool table ever hope to compete with a gold trombone? Ra, 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 da, 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 ra, ra. Remember, my friends, what a handful of trumpet players did to the famous, fabled walls of Jericho. Oh, billiard parlor walls come a-tumbling down. Oh, a band will do it, my friends. Oh, yes, I said a boys band. Do you hear me? I said River City gotta have a boys band, and I mean she needs it today. Well, Professor Harold Hill's on hand. River City's gonna have her boys band. As sure as the Lord made little green apples, and that band's gonna be in uniform. Johnny, Willie, Teddy, Fred. And you'll see the glitter of crashing cymbals. And you'll hear the thunder of rolling drums and the shimmer of trumpets. Tantara! And you'll feel something akin to the electric thrill I once enjoyed when Gilmore, Liberati, Pat Conway, the great creator, W.C. Handy, and John Philip Sousa all came to town on the very same historic day. 76 trombones led the big parade, with 110 cornets close at hand. They were followed by rows and rows of the finest virtuosos, the queen of every famous band. 76 trombones caught the morning sun, with 110 cornets right behind. There were more than 1,000 reeds springing up like weeds. There were horns of every shape and kind. There were copper bottom timpani and horse platoon, thundering, thundering all along the way. Double bell euphoniums and big bassoons, each bassoon having his big fan say. There were 50 mounted cannon in the battery, thundering, thundering louder than before. Clarinets of every size and trumpeters would improvise a full octave higher than the score.
Mayor Shin happens to own the billiard parlor, so he's not too thrilled with any of this. So the school board, in the meantime, is bickering among themselves. He goes over to them and tells them to get Harold Hill's credentials. Where did he go to school? How is he trained? Why is he here? But Harold is very smart. He gets them to sing as a barbershop quartet to distract them, and they sing a little barbershop. Harold also sets up Zanita, the mayor's eldest daughter, with Tommy, the troublemaker Tommy, and persuades Tommy to work as his assistant. He tries to spark some interest from Marion, but is rejected yet again. But Harold is determined to win her over. There are rumblings that she may have a past, and he sings a song, The Sadder But Wiser Girl.
No wide-eyed, eager, wholesome, innocent Sunday school teacher for me. That kind of gal spins webs no spider ever... Now listen, boy. A gal who trades on all that purity merely wants to trade my independence for her security. The only affirmative she will file refers to marching down the aisle. No golden, glorious, gleaming, pristine goddess. No, sir, for no Diana do I play fawn. I can tell you that right now. I snarl, I hiss. How can ignorance be compared to bliss? I spark, I fizz. For the lady who knows what time it is, I cheer and I rave. For the virtue I'm too late to say, the sadder but wiser girl for me. Bright-eyed, blushing, breathless baby doll baby. No, sir, that kind of child ties knots. No sailor ever knew. I preferred to take a chance on a more adult romance. No dewy young miss who keeps resisting all the time she keeps insisting. No wide-eyed, wholesome, innocent female. No, sir, why, she's the fisherman, I'm the fish, you see. What? I flinch, I shy. When the lass with the delicate air goes by, I smile, I grin. When the gal with a touch of sin walks in, I hope and I pray for Hester to win just one more A. The sadder but wiser girl's the girl for me. The sadder but wiser girl for me.
All right, in the meantime, the town ladies are very excited about the band, and the ladies' dance committee is very excited that Harold is going to plan to have a dance soon. He mentions Marion, but they gossip to him. They don't like her, telling Harold that she had an affair with a now deceased miser who willed the library building to the town, but he left all the books to Marion. They warn Harold that she advocates dirty books by Chaucer, Rabelais, and Balzac. The school board arrives to review Harold's credentials, but then, as usual, he leads them in a song and slips away. So we're going to hear now, the ladies start singing Pick a Little, Talk a Little, which is very, very clever about women gossiping. And then, on top of that, the school board starts singing Good Night Ladies in Barbershop, and you have the two songs going on at the same time. Really a lot of fun. So Pick a Little, Talk a Little, and Good Night Ladies.
Pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, chick, 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 talk a lot, pick a little more, pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, chick, 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 talk a lot, pick a little more, pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, chick, 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 talk a lot, pick a little more, pick a little, talk a little, pick a little, talk a little, chick, 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 chick.
Professor, her kind of woman doesn't belong on any committee. Of course, I shouldn't tell you this, but she advocates dirty books.
Books?
Chaucer, Rabelais, Balzac. And the worst thing, of course, I shouldn't tell you this.
I'll tell. A man lived on my street. Let me tell.
No, I'll tell. She made brazen overtures to a man who never had a friend in this town till she came here.
Oh, yes, that woman made brazen overtures with a two-page guarantee to the golden glint-eyed silver voice with a counterfeit ring. Just melt her down and you'll reveal a lump of lead as cold as steel. Yeah, where women's hearts should be.
He left from her city, the library building, but he left all the books to her.
Chaucer.
Professor, sorry, we need your credentials. Why, certainly, gentlemen. I have just what you want over my hotel. Please come with me. Good night, lady. Good night, lady.
one. Really great. All right, so the next day, Harold walks into the library. And he's really determined to win over Marion the librarian and sings this wonderful song.
Marion, Madam Librarian, oh, what can I do, my dear, to catch your ear? I love you madly, madly, Madam Librarian. Marion, heaven help us if the library caught on fire and the volunteer host brigade men had to whisper the news to Marion. Madam Librarian. Oh, what can I say, my dear, to make it clear? I need you badly, badly, Madam Librarian. Marion, if I stumbled and I busted my whatchamacallit, I could lie on your floor unnoticed, though my body had turned to carrion. Madam Librarian. Now in the moonlight, sing it in the moonlight, and a fellow would know that his darling had heard every word of his song with the moonlight helping along. But when I tried in here to tell you, dear, I love you madly, madly, Madam Librarian. Marion is a long lost cause I can never win, for the civilized world accepts as unforgivable sin any talking out loud with any librarian such as Marion. Madam Librarian.
So in this sequence, it's really kind of neat. She forgets her decorum and dances with Harold and teenagers also. It's really a very, very nice sequence. Harold tries to kiss her. It's all over then. She tries to slap him. However, she misses him and hits Tommy, his assistant, instead. All right, so with Tommy's help, Harold signs up all the boys in town to be in the band, including Marion's brother, Winthrop, the one with the lisp. Mrs. Peru, Marion's mother, kind of likes Harold and tries to find out why Marion is not interested. And in this next song, My White Knight, Marion describes her ideal man.
Nor an angel with wings, just someone to love me, who is not ashamed of a few nice things. My white knight, what my heart would say if it only knew how. Please, dear Venus, show me. Quiet man, a gentleman, a straightforward and honest man to sit with me in a cottage somewhere in the state of Iowa, and I would like him to be more interested in me than he is in himself.
what makes Shakespeare and Beethoven great. Him I could love till I die. Him I could love till I die. My white knight, not a Lancelot, nor an angel with wings, just someone to love me, who is not ashamed of a few nice things. My white knight, let me walk with him while the others ride by. Walk and love him till I die.
So we hear this wonderful outpouring of emotion. But in the meantime, Marion has found evidence against Harold. She'd been doing some research and found the Indiana State Educational Journal that has some damning evidence. She sets out to give it to Mayor Shin, but they're interrupted by the arrival of the Wells Fargo wagon, which is delivering the band instruments, so everybody is very, very excited. So here is the Wells Fargo wagon.
A hawk of Wells Fargo wagon is a coming down the street.
Oh, please let it be for me.
A hawk of Wells Fargo wagon is a coming down the street.
I wish I knew what it could be.
COD. It could be curtains,
or dishes, or a thermal boiler.
Or it could be.
Yes, it could be. Yes, you're right. It surely could be.
Something special.
Something very, very special now.
Just for me.
Oh, the Wells Fargo wagon is a coming down the street. Oh, don't let it pass my door. Oh, the Wells Fargo wagon is a coming down the street. I wish I knew what he was coming for.
From Fresno.
The VAR and Senate cannon for the courthouse square.
Oh, the Wells Fargo wagon, it's a coming now. I don't know how I can ever wait to see. It could be something for someone who is no relation, but it could be something special just for me.
Ending, that's because that's the end of Act One, so they have to do something like that to rev up the crowd so they'll clap. All right, but while this is going on, Winthrop forgets to be shy and self-conscious because he's so happy about his new cornet. We heard him singing in that with his little lisp going on. And Marion begins to see Harold in a new light. She sees the self-confidence that's starting to happen with her own brother and some of the other boys. She tears out the incriminating page out of the journal before giving the book to Mayor Shin. So she's starting to change her mind about him. Oh, by the way, these examples, whenever we hear Winthrop, played by a very, very young Ron Howard, who ended up being Opie then in the Andy Griffith Show. He starred in Happy Days, a TV sitcom, and is now, you know, a wonderful director in Hollywood. So he's had really an incredible career, and I believe this is where he really started making his mark. All right, so Act Two, curtain opens up. The ladies are rehearsing their classical dance in the school gym, while the school board, the quartet, is practicing for the ice cream social coming up. Marcellus and the town's teenagers interrupt the ladies' practice, though. They take over the gym and they start to dance. This wonderful choreography going on. Harold grabs Marion to dance with her, and all the teenagers join in. Regarding Winthrop's cornet, Marion kind of questions Harold about his claim that you don't have to bother with the notes. He explains that this is what he calls the think system, and he arranges to call on Marion to discuss it further. The town ladies then ask Marion to join their dance committee, since she was so dear dancing with Professor Hill. They've also changed their minds about the books. They don't think they're so dirty anymore. They tell her that the professor told us to read those books, and we simply adored them all. That night, the school board tries to collect Harold's credentials once again, but he gets them to sing and slips away. So we're going to hear now the quartet singing Lida Rose, that Harold has gotten them to sing. In the meantime, Marion is sitting on her front porch thinking of Harold, and she sings Will I Ever Tell You. So these two, just like what we heard before, the two songs, first sung separately and then simultaneously. It's another example of Broadway counterpoint songs, and they're songs with separate lyrics, separate melodies, but they harmonize and they're designed to be sung together. So we're going to hear Lida Rose and Will I Ever Tell You.
Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, to get the sun back. Fine, light a rose, oh, warm.
come back in Boston. Light rolls, I'm home again, rolls about a thousand years have shone. Ding dong ding, I can hear the chapel bell chime.
And the great beat
ding dong ding, at the least suggestion, I've got the questions.
Mrs. Peru about Harold's hometown, Gary, Indiana. With evidence against Harold, hoping to tell Mayor Shin. He only has a few minutes before his train leaves, but stops to flirt with Marion. She delays him, so he won't have time to deliver the evidence, eventually kissing him. As the train whistle blows, she pushes him away. Charlie angrily tells Marion that Harold has a girl in every county in Illinois, and that's 102 counties. Harold arrives, and after he reminds her of the untrue rumors he's heard about her, she convinces herself that Charlie invented everything he told her. They agree to meet at the footbridge, where Marion tells him the difference he's made in her life. And now here is the song, very famous song, Till There Was You.
You
romantic moment, though, is shattered. Marcellus arrives, saying the police are on their way. He tells Harold to take the money and run, but Harold refuses to leave. He returns to Marion, and Marion tells him she's known since 3 days after he arrived that he's a fraud. But she loves him, and she gives him the incriminating page out of that Indiana State Educational Journal. She leaves, promising to see him later at the social. With his schemes for the boys' band and Marion proceeding even better than he planned, Harold confidently sings 76 trombones. As he overhears Marion singing "Goodnight, My Someone," Harold realizes he really is in love with Marion, and he and Marion alternate singing a bit of each other's songs. And listen closely. "Goodnight, My Someone" is the exact same melody, the same tune as 76 trombones. "Goodnight, My Someone" is in 3/4 time, like a waltz tempo, and 76 trombones, of course, is in a march time.
While 110 cornets played the air, then I modestly took my place as the one and only bass, and I oompa'd up and down the square. With 110 cornets right behind, of every shape and kind. Sweet dreams be yours, dear, if dreams there be.
While 110 cornets play the air,
I wish I may, and I wish I might. Now good night, my someone, good night.
Leads a meeting in the high school gym to decide what to do with Harold, saying, "Well, where's the band? Where's the band?" Marion defends Harold. Tommy enters as a drum major, followed by all the boys in uniform and their instruments. Marion urges Harold to lead the River City Boys Band in Beethoven's Minuet in G. Of course, they play it, and it's a disaster. All right, very limited musical ability. However, the parents in the audience are enraptured by the sight of their little darlings playing the music. Even Mayor Shin is won over, and the townspeople cheer, and Harold is released into Marion's arms, and they all sing 76 trombones again. So that's the end of the